The health budget for the financial year 2023-2024 has been reduced to 6.5% from 7.2% in the current financial year. Civil society budget advocates are concerned by the drop in the allocation for blood collection from 23 billion shillings this financial year to 21 billion shillings. This means that Uganda Blood Transfusion Services will only be able to collect 300,000 units of blood against the needed 450,000 units, something which puts a big risk to lives of people, especially mothers giving birth. Still in the health sector, National Medical Stores projects to receive 581 billion shillings for procurement of essential medicine. Unfortunately, this is below the projected essential medicine needed of 782 billion shillings, which means that cases of drug stockouts in public health facilities will persist. The activists also called for increased budget allocations for the agriculture sector, especially agriculture extension service funding.
To have health centers functional. Because research shows that when patients go to health facilities and they cannot access medicines, they will not come back next time. And so it is important that we invest in medicines if we want to strengthen functionality of these health facilities. The deficit that we have of about 201 billion shillings is critical. It is one of the things that we need to deal with. You all remember that at the end of the year, we had shortages across the country of medicines. And then we, at that point, were arguing that, you see, the problem is not what Ministry of Health was telling us about complications in terms of delivery. The complication is actually that we have limited resources for this. And from the analysis
for production, we commend government's effort in upscaling the use of technologies that can be easily adopted by the smaller farmers. But the challenge still remains in the extension services, just like my colleague talked about it. Every technology has to go with extension. And we think for our water, for production technologies to work for the smaller farmers, we need to invest in that extension services so that they're meaningful.
The activists advised government to balance its budget by increasing domestic resources, cut down on its borrowing appetite to finance non-core projects, as well as close the gaps that lead to swindling of public resources.
We had sent a benchmark of 12.5 of our own revenue to service domestic debt. Right now, we are at 24.1%. Now, this definitely cripples our capacity to deliver services, but especially, you know, our road network. But it should also be noted that government in the last financial year used commercial loans of 2.4.5 trillion to cover our recurrent expenditure, including wage and administration expenses. So the practice of borrowing to cover salaries is amongst the risks we are seeing on our debt management portfolio.
Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.